So today we are just outside of Stanley, Idaho, in which is the Forest Service has come in and thinned this for hazard fuel reduction. And we've got a lot of material here waiting to be used. Some of this material will go to firewood, a lot of it, some of it to post and poles. But there's a lot of material that won't be. And our goal here is to take that material and in this particular setting, create pellets that can then be taken to the market and sold.
And our goal is to try and retrieve something from the waste. We're currently experimenting with three different types of machines. We take the slash, we run it through a chipper, it goes through a hammer mill here at the end of the trailer, it's then blown into the hopper, it goes from there into a series of three machines. So testing the same basic material from the same slash pile should give us an idea on which machine will come out, hopefully head and shoulders above the others. We're learning a lot right now about moisture content, lack of lignin, the natural binder that's in all wood. This particular wood is lodgepole. It's low in lignin, so we're experimenting with moisture content to add to the mix. We're using different binders. Typically what we're going to produce is some form of compressed wood pellet. Whether it resembles the conventional pressed wood pellet you use in your pellet stove at home, or it's a large diameter piece of compressed presto type log.
When I think about it, you know, mills, foresters, state agencies, we're always addressing slash and residuals, so why, if this works, why wouldn't we? Especially when we have, you know, certain areas that have such a high demand for fuel wood for their primary heating source.
Our goal here is to find uses for that unmerchantable material, to be able to take the slash and be able to make a product out of it. One of the reasons that it's been so difficult is because there's a high cost of transportation. It is very difficult and very costly to take material, particularly that is small, particularly that has water in it and a lot of air, and move it great distances and then be able to only sell it for pennies on the dollar. You just can't afford to do that. So one of the things that we're trying here is to produce products on site. And we have a manufacturer out of Salmon, Idaho, Commander Chassis, that has developed a portable pellet mill. The idea is to come in and be able to take material that has been created because of these treatments and be able to make a product out of that, and that can then be sold and be able to reduce the cost of the overall treatment, particularly reduce the cost of disposal.
This is one of the large presto type logs that come out of a hydraulic extrusion machine, and it's fairly dense, but you can see that material. It's a cross-section of coarse and fine type material. And essentially, this has been densified just by pressure. These are probably much more like what people are familiar with for their wood stove. This is a granular sort of feedstock. So it works. It's a bit of a chore. It's as much alchemy and art as it is science, and that's what we're finding out, and hopefully we'll get it pinned down a little closer as we go. Our goal is to take a trash, unusable product and turn it into a heating source, a fuel source, something to run boilers with, something to not only reutilize a waste product, but actually to get some good out of that.
I'm excited about what's happening in the biomass world. There is a lot of people working on creating some exciting things, whether it's a portable pellet facility, whether it's a mobile pyrolysis unit, whether it's getting into bioplastics and those kind of things. There is a need, and there is a lot of people working on it, and it will be successful.